Everybody knows to stay far, far away from MSG. The only problem is no one seems to know exactly why. These days, us consumers want to know more about the foods we eat, but despite this spirit of investigation, some food myths remain completely untouched, and the toxic, poisonous, cancerous, energy-sucking, headache-inducing reputation of MSG is one of the biggest, lingering food myths of all. MSG, or monosodium glutamate, is a flavor enhancer that is responsible for cranking up the sensation of umami flavors on our tongue. Umami can be described as a savory flavor and was named after the Japanese word umai, which means delicious. The effects of MSG were first discovered in 1908 by chemist KIKUNAE IKEDA, who began studying seaweed, which had been used for centuries by chefs to improve the flavor of foods. As it turned out, the flavor enhancement was coming from an amino acid called L-glutamate. Glutamate is found in tons of common foods that are rich in protein. Meats, dairy products, and vegetables all have glutamate. In fact, our very own bodies produce glutamate through the Krebs cycle when metabolizing food. So in other words, glutamate is very abundant and a very common part of our diet. Funny thing is, MSG is a sodium salt form of glutamic acid. So basically, the monosodium part just means that it's easier to sprinkle on your dish. Okay, so here's the question. If your body makes this compound, and it's so common, then how come everyone thinks this stuff is bad for you? It all started in a letter to the New England Journal of Medicine in 1968, written by a scientist who described the unpleasant after effects he felt after eating Chinese food. He dubbed his symptoms Chinese restaurant syndrome, which he broadly described as a numbness at the back of the neck, gradually radiating to both arms and the back, and a general weakness and palpitation. This is, of course, after stuffing his face with Chinese food. The journal suggested that MSG was the culprit. Based on research in the decades that followed, the scientific consensus seemed to be that MSG can temporarily affect a select few when consumed in huge quantities on an empty stomach, but it's perfectly safe for the vast majority of people. And still, MSG's bad reputation persists today. What's really kind of remarkable is that you'll see signs or labels on foods at Chinese restaurants that say no MSG added, to which most people think, great, it's safe here, let's chow down. Little do they realize that when they douse their MSG-free food with soy sauce, they're actually intensely loading it up with glutamate. You honestly can't get away from this stuff, but it's really not a problem. L-glutamic acid is one of 20 amino acids that make up natural proteins, and as such, the World Health Organization and FDA have christened it completely safe to ingest, as with all things, in moderation. Okay, so there's one fundamental lesson in this food myth that everyone should take away. If someone tells you that something is bad for you and you can't get a definitive answer as to why, it's your job to dig in and find out for yourself. This is what science is all about, not accepting something as truth without proper evidence. Make sure to check down in the video description for a link to an infographic about MSG by our pals over at Compound Interest. And don't forget to spread the word and subscribe.